first generation by using immigration teams might be such a good idea for a revolutionary dynamic world yet in globalization. And then we're going to discuss the relationship between diversity and the immigration teams that we are specifically studying in this paper, which are based on a probabilistic model. Then we're going to present a taxonomy of certain immigration chains derived from that model. Then, of course, we're going to present the proposed immigrants-based diversity generator, which is the tool that we are using for experimenting with the continuous optimization benchmarks. And finally, we will go through methodology, results, discussion, and final marks of the work. So here's the problem we're trying to solve, which is, how can one generate diversity in dynamic AMO such that it allows for improving the robustness of population of candidate solutions in face of a wide range of changes? So by robustness here, we mean that we would like to be able to maintain a diverse set of high quality solutions in the population throughout all the optimization process, regardless of the changes that might occur in the original definition of the problem. So what are the kind of changes that might happen in this problem? In a multi-objective problem, changes can happen here in the decision space or in the objective space. So in fact, it can happen in either any of these four combinations between type of changes between both spaces. So let me take, for example, the type one scenario of change here. The Pareto set, which is the points of the decision space which are mapped to the frame of surface in the objective space which are trying to approximate, which is known as the Pareto front. So this Pareto set changes, but the Pareto front does not. And these kind of situations are quite common and of practical interest in many real-world optimization problems. So in such dynamic scenarios, the traditional more objective evolutionary algorithms that we have today are not always capable of dealing with the changes that can occur in both spaces. And why is that? So one of the reasons is because the standard variation operators, which are used mainly for generating diversity, for sampling new points in the decision space, they are simply not enough to generate the suitable diversity levels that we need to cope with these environmental changes. So, in order to generate diversity in this world, we are going to apply the immigrants chains that have been already thoroughly studied for single objective optimization for a reason. And the reason is that they are quite flexible, they are presenting really good results, and we would like to extend and to learn all the good features that make it perform so well in single objective optimization. So the goals of this paper, we can state firstly that it's to build on a potentially robust and general diversity generation framework based on immigration chains for dynamic AMO. And secondly, to assess the properties of the proposed model, and as well as perform a parametric variation effects study on both diversity and ideal volume, which is an overall measure of the quality of the population that you are trying to evolve towards the optimization. So why do we believe that this is such a good way to go? Why do we believe that immigration chains might do well to solve dynamic AMOs? Firstly, because immigration teams provides a better separation between diversity generation and optimization towards the Pareto front. In fact, you can use virtually any mechanism that you are interested in with, and you can simply integrate the immigration teams to that. And secondly, because by providing this separation, it also highlights the importance of diversity generation for dynamic models, which we believe that is the key issue when trying to solve dynamic multi-objective optimization problem. So let's take a look to the model that we are using in this paper, which is a probabilistic model. We have our population X, which is actually a mixture of two random variables, Y and Z, in which Y represents the distribution of the subpopulation of immigrants, and Z represents the distribution of the subpopulation of the whole subpopulation, the subpopulation that you are maintaining across generations and their survival. So we have a diagram here, which was taken from a paper at the, in the Journal of Theoretical Biology. This is a model of immigration, and we have simplified this model for this paper. For this paper, we are working with only one parameter, alpha, which we call the immigration rate. So this immigration rate alpha is actually equivalent to this alpha 2 here in this diagram, which means that we are modeling the immigration rate from the immigrant subpopulation towards the global population max. And alpha 1 is set to 0, meaning that we are only interested in an one-way immigration influx from Y to X. So let me give you an example here. We have here a distribution of candidate solutions in the real line, which were drawn by these models of subpopulation. And we have exactly the same models here and below, but the difference is that we are working with different immigration rates. So in the chart above, we have 70% of the immigrant subpopulation drawn from the model Y. And in the below chart, we have the complementary immigration rate, meaning that only 30% of the population X is composed by immigrants. So we are very interested in measuring diversity in such kind of models. And one of the things that we show in this paper is that under special conditions, we can show that the expected genetic diversity measured on the decision space can be actually the same for such kind of models under complementary immigration chains. That's because of the distributional symmetry of the space. So one of the first things that people would try to do when measuring diversity is to calculate kind of centroid-based diversity indicators. So the first thing they usually do is to compute the center of mass of the population and to compute the summation of the Euclidean distances between each individual to the center of mass. And let me show what happened in the probabilistic model. The centroid of the population is actually the expected value of this model, which are denoted by X of alpha. So when you do the math, you end up concluding that the centroid is actually a convex combination between the random variables Y and Z, and therefore it's a random variable by itself. So we can also compute, for example, the variance of the population. But the important thing here is that we conclude that the expected genetic diversity is actually the expectation taken from the variance of the population, plus accounting for a term of uncertainty here, which is the variance of the centroid, because the centroid is also a random variable. And our main conclusion is that by studying this model, if we would like to obtain the same expected genetic diversity for two immigration chains models under complementary immigration rates, all you have to do is to have equal subpopulation variances. So this is a sufficient condition for that. And this is illustrated in this chart here, in which we vary the immigration rate from 0 to 1, and see what happens with the expected genetic diversity here in this axis. So we see that when the absolute difference between the various social populations are equal, here, when they are zero, we get a symmetric distribution here in which actually the expected genetic diversity is the same under complementary immigration rates. And but as we allow this difference to diverge from zero, this symmetry is broken. So the really important thing here is to realize that under the same approximated genetic diversity levels, one can really represent and refer to many different situations, quite the opposite situations of distribution of candidate solutions in the decision space. So this can really cause some confusions when trying to analyze and trying to relate diversity with the quality of the population. And this is in some way reflected the results that we are going to show by the end of this presentation. Another thing that we can do with this probability model here is to devise a taxonomy, which is not really that different from the taxonomy which already exists in the literature, but we really wanted to do that for the sake of completeness and for the sake of clarity. So we say that an immigration chain is correlated when its subpopulations are statistically correlated. It's uncorrelated if they are not. And there is the third option here, the hybrid, when you add k immigrant subpopulation, provided that the immigration rates individually sum up to one. So it's just a notation that we use next. So let's instantiate this model. Let's build a really concrete models based on the framework that we have shown. But first, before doing that, we really need to answer these four questions here for designing the diversity generators. First, how to generate diversity? So obviously, any sampling process over the decision space might do the job for sampling new points in the decision space. So we are going to show two of such processes next. Second question, when diversity level should be increased? We are assuming that the changes here are unpredictable. Of course, we know that they are not unpredictable because we are simulating these changes, and therefore we know which changes will happen, but we are pretending that we don't know, and therefore, one of the best possible ways of dealing with this problem is to assume that you need to generate diversity every single generation. So we are going to create immigrants and insert them into the population at each generation. Number three, how many solutions should be generated and are discarded? So in this model, we are clearly controlling this, answering this question by the immigration rate. And finally, which solution should be discarded? Among the many possibilities that we have chosen replace the worst policy, which works quite well for single objective optimization. But the difficulty here in multi objectives is how do you define individually which are the best solutions or which are the worst solutions? Because they are, in many situations, non-comparable. You don't have a total order in a vectorial space. So we are simply taking the partial order relation that is used in the NSG2 algorithm, which is very well known, which considers the Pareto rank and tiebreakers using the problem distance and to identify which solutions are preferable to be replaced. So the first concrete model that we have, we name it the correlated immigrant-based diversity generator, and it's actually an extension of the LTS-based immigrants GA for simple objective optimization. The basic idea is that we are going to take the elite of the population and perform mutations over the elite, and these mutated individuals will be used to replace a certain portion of the population to generate diversity. So again, we're going to use the partial relation order by NSGA2 to identify these elites and to identify the worst solutions that shall be replaced. The next model that we have is, in fact, very simple.